In this video, I explain constructions and working of check valve. Check valve is a one type of direction control valve, means it is used to control the direction of working fluid. Suppose it is used in a hydraulic system, means they are control the direction of oil. Suppose it is used in pneumatic systems, then they control the directions of the compressed air or a gas. Check valve is unidirectional valve. Unidirectional means it is control the flow in a one directional. Okay, so unidirectional is also known as the non-return valve, which allow working fuel to flow only in a one directional. Means from the check valve, oil is supplied in a only one directional. It will not allow working fluid in a other direction. Means working fluid is only flow in a one directional from the check valve. That's why it is called as the unidirectional valve or a non-return valve. Now here you see, this is the diagrams of the check valve. So this is the inlet A and this is the outlet B. So from the arrow you can understand. Now let's we see what are the various components of the check valve. So figure show a check valve. It has the spring loaded ball or a conical poppet inside the valve housing. So this sectional view is indicate the valve housing. Okay, inside this valve housing, it have the two component. First one is the spring and second one is the ball. Okay, so check valve is a different two type. In a first type, the ball is used. Right now you see this figure. In this figure, that is a ball is used. Okay. And second type is here the odd word is mentioned. Okay. Here you see that is a spring loaded ball. So in this image, you see this is the spring and at the end of the spring, ball is there. Okay. So it is called as the spring loaded ball. And second type is the conical poppet. So instance of this ball, the conical shape poppet is used. So this is the second types of the check valve. Okay. But here we see that is a spring loaded ball types. Now here you see this is the symbol of the check valve. Means suppose in a we draw the any hydraulics or the pneumatic systems in which the check valve is indicates by using this type of the symbol. When working fluid is supplied to a port A, means from this port the working fluid is supplied. Okay, and the working fluid is exert the pressures on the ball against the spring force. Okay, so when this working fluid is supplied, means suppose oils or a compressed air or gas is supplied, at that time this working fluid is apply some force. Okay, working fluid is applied the some force on this ball and the ball is applied the force on the spring and spring is start to compress and the ball is move away from this A port due to the pressures of the working fluids. Hence the ball will be lifted off from its seats. Means ball is lifted from its seats. Means here you see this is the seats of the ball and so ball is go away from the seats. It is called as the lifted off from its seat and create a passage of working fluid to flow. Hence the working fluid can flow from part A to part B. I mean, suppose this ball is here, so it is a seating area of this ball, so working fluid is not supplied from A to B, but due to these pressures of the working fluids the ball is go away from its seats and it's open the passage for the working fluid. So here you see this passage is open. That means the whatever the working fluid is coming from the A port, it is supplied it to this port B. Means this A port is inlet and B port is the outlet. Now here you see this is the second diagram. Means second case is that suppose the oil is coming from this B port. Here you see this arrow is indicate towards the B port. Means oil is enter from the B ports. Okay, so here the by mistake this arrow size is different from the A ports, so it is wrong. Here the arrow is outlet, but this oil is not coming. That's why when working fluid is supplied in opposite direction. Opposite direction means the working fluid is supplied from the port B to port B. The working fluid force ball to sit firmly in its seats. Hence the passage is closed by the ball and the working fluid cannot flow from port B to port A. Means the working fluid coming from the port B, it's applied the force on this ball and the ball is go toward its seats. Means ball is coming on dead seats. So here the passage is closed and the passage is closed means the working fluid is not supplied from port B to port A. So that means the check valve is only supplied the fluids from a one directional. That's why it is mentioned as the unidirectional in the first lines and it is also the non-return, because the oil or a working fluid is not returns from the B port to the A ports. That's why it is called as the non-return valve. Check valve is an important valve which finds application in many circuit for obtaining the reverse free flow. Reverse free flow means reverse is not possible, it is called as the reverse free flow. In one direction, working fluid has to flow through the flow control valve, sequence valve H, means in a one direction. So working fluid is flowing in one direction. So working fluid has flow through the flow control valve, sequence valve H, and in another direction it shall be free flow. In such a case, check valve is connected parallel to the main valve, means with the flow control valves and with the sequence valve, the check valve is used, okay, for the reverse flow of the working substance. So thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to the OHP and other subject of the mechanical engineering. For the OHP, various link is provided in descriptions as well as in a card mean on a top right screen of your mobiles or laptop. You see the eye symbols. For other subject, I request to visit the playlist.